discuss about the amphibian heart. Now let's see what is there in the case of amphibian. In the case of amphibian, the heart is a three-chambered heart. Here, the heart is three-chambered heart. We are talking about the two or the primary chambers. हम two chambers के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, तो there are three chambers. These out of these three, two auricles are there. Two auricles. And these auricles are divided into the right and the left auricles. Means auricular septum is present there, by which the auricles are divided into the right auricles and the left auricles. So these two are the auricles and they have one ventricle. They have one ventricle. So in this way they have the three true chambers. When we talk about the accessory chambers, agar hum accessory chambers ki baat kare, the conus arteriosus is remain, sorry, sinus venosus is remain here as it is. So in the case of sinus venosus is present here, sinus venosus is present here, whereas the conus arteriosus, jo conus arteriosus jo humne dekha tha in the case of the fishes, fishes ke heart mein conus arteriosus jo structure thi, this get converted, it get merged with the aorta, so it's arteriosus and it converted into the truncus arteriosus. So what is happened here? Here in the case of the conus arteriosus is merged with the aorta and converted into a different kind of structure which is known as truncus arteriosus, whereas sinus venosus remain as it is, like that was in the case of the fishes. As we have seen that the fishes heart was the tubular heart, where the atrium was present at the lower side and the ventricle was present at the upper side. Is tarah ki structure jo thi humne fishes ke heart mein dekhi thi. But as the evolution take place, jaise jaise evolution ho raha hai, that atrium they comes up the above side, jo atrium hai wo upar ki taraf aa gaye hain, and the ventricles they get converted at the, they remain present at the lower side. So in this case, in the case of amphibian heart, we can say that the lower chambers are the ventricles, whereas the upper chambers are the atrium. So just keep remember, in the case of fishes, there was the atrium was present at the lower side. But here, in the case of the amphibians, the atriums, they comes at the upper side of the heart. So these two are the atrium, that is the left atrium, and this one is the right atrium. The left atrium and right atrium, these are divided in the two different chambers through the septum, whereas the ventricle is a single chamber structure. There is no partition in the case of ventricles in amphibian's heart. So these two atrium, they receive blood from the different body regions. Alag alag jagah se yahan pe blood jo hai wo receive kiya jayega. कैसे होगा वो देखते हैं. द लेफ्ट एट्रियम, दिस लेफ्ट एट्रियम इज रिसीव ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द लंग्स. लेफ्ट एट्रियम रिसीव ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द लंग्स, व्हेयरएज द राइट एट्रियम, दैट राइट एट्रियम दे रिसीव द डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड थ्रू द साइनस वेनोसस. वेयर फर्स्ट द ब्लड विल कम इनटू द साइनस वेनोसस एंड थ्रू साइनस वेनोसस, दिस इज द साइनस वेनोसस, receive deoxygenated blood through the body parts by the sinus venosus, and through sinus venosus the blood will comes into the right atrium, and through right atrium the blood will goes into the ventricle. Similarly, as here the left atrium is receiving the oxygenated blood from the lungs, and from here this oxygenated blood goes to the ventricles. So here what is happening, deoxygenated blood from the right atrium and oxygenated blood from the left atrium is get mixed into the ventricle. Yahan pe aake blood ki mixing ho rahi hai. So in the case of ventricle, we can say that here the mixed blood is present. The blood get mixed here. Oxygenated, this is the oxygenated blood, and this one is the deoxygenated blood. Both these two types of the blood get mixed into the single chamber ventricles, and through the ventricles, this mixed blood is transported out. Be transported out through this tubular structure. This is the tubular structure which is the truncus arteriosus. This is the truncus arteriosus which form by merging of conus arteriosus with the aorta. So yahan pe kya hua hai, conus arteriosus jo hai wo aorta ke sath merge hoke truncus arteriosus mein convert ho gaya hai, and this is the truncus arteriosus. Through the truncus arteriosus, this mixed blood is transported to the body parts. Yahan se body blood ka transportation ho raha hai. So here we can see that this blood is transporting the mixed blood. This kind of heart is known as atriovenous heart. It's atriovenous heart. as the case of fishes, we know that the fish's heart is transporting the deoxygenated blood. That's why it was known as the venous heart. Whereas it is transporting the mixed type of blood, so it is known as atriovenous heart. तो इस तरीके के heart को हम atriovenous heart बोलते हैं. यहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं कि evolution की वजह से atrium जो है उनमें तो divideation हो चुका है. यहाँ पे तो partition form हो गया है. But the ventricles, they do not get divided. अगर सर्कुलेशन की हम बात करें, the circulation which is present in the case of amphibians is a double circulation. They have double circulation. This kind of double circulation is known as double circulation. Why we are calling it a double circulation? Because here or here also the blood is transported to the heart. Twice being transported to the body organ. Body organs या body part तक transport करने से पहले यहाँ पे heart two bar, two times pass हो रहा है through the heart. Once in the course of the oxygenated blood, we can say that oxygenated blood first comes from the lungs into the left atrium, and through left atrium is goes to the ventricles. From ventricles is goes to the body part, and from body parts is come back to the heart by the sinus venosus to right atrium. So here the blood is passing through the heart two times in a single cardiac cycle. This type of circulation is known as double circulation. But as we can say that blood which is transported here is a mixed blood, so it can be considered as an incomplete circulation. But it's a double circulation because the blood is transported through the heart two times before being transported to the body parts. So this is about the amphibian heart, where we have seen that the heart is become the three chamber. आगे हम देखेंगे, as we will go on to the next level in the case of the reptiles. Here the heart will further divide it and it will become the three chambered heart. Now we will discuss about the reptilian hearts. As the case of the amphibian, we say that the heart is a three chambered heart. But in here, in the case of the amphibian, here it's look like a three chambered heart. At the same, two atriums are there, that is left atrium, right atrium and ventricle. But it's not actually known as the three chambered heart. This kind of heart, that is the reptilian heart, is also known as three and a half chambered heart. This kind of heart, in the case of the reptiles heart is three and a half chambered heart. Is it? थ्री एंड हाफ चैम्बर. हमने थ्री एंड हाफ चैम्बर क्यों बोला है, जैसे कि amphibians के केसेस में हमने देखा था टू एट्रियम वन वेंट्रिकल था. बट हियर इन द केस ऑफ द रेप्टाइल्स हार्ट, वी कैन से दैट द वेंट्रिकल्स आर पार्शियली डिवाइडेड विद ईच अदर. यहाँ पे पार्शियल एक सेप्टम फॉर्म हो गया, पार्शियली डिवाइडेशन हो गया है वेंट्रिकल्स का, जिसकी वजह से हम हार्ट को थ्री एंड हाफ चैम्बर बोल रहे हैं. Atrias are completely divided into the two chambers, right atrium and left atrium, but the ventricles are partially divided. This kind of heart is known as three and half chamber heart. This three and half chamber heart जो है इसमें the main chambers or the primary chambers are the two atrias and the one ventricles. Now come on to the accessory chambers. अगर अब हम accessory chambers की बात करें, accessory chambers जो यहाँ पे present है वो कौन कौन से हैं? The first is sinus venosus. Sinus venosus is there in the accessory chambers. The sinus venosus is present, but it's reduced. In the case of reptiles, it's a reduced sinus venosus. Second type of accessory chambers, that is the truncus arteriosus. In the case of amphibians, the truncus arteriosus were there, but here the truncus arteriosus is converted into the three main blood vessels. So, क्या हुआ? Sinus venosus तो present है, but it's present in the reduced form. It is the reduced here, but the truncus arteriosus is converted or formed the three main blood vessels. It formed the three main blood vessels. Three main blood vessels बन गई हैं. वो three main blood vessels कौन सी हैं? देखते हैं. What blood vessels are formed by the truncus arteriosus? The two are the systemic arch. Two are the systemic arch and the one is the pulmonary arch. Pulmonary arch. So these systemic arch and the pulmonary arch are formed by the truncus arteriosus. It's converted into the systemic and pulmonary arch. As we know that the evolution, as the evolution take place, in the case of the fishes, where the tubular heart is there, and it was the two chambered heart. One atria, one ventricle. But as we come on to the next group, higher level, that is the amphibian, the heart becomes the three chambered, where atrias get divided completely, but ventricles do not show any dividation. So heart becomes three chambered heart. Here, in the case of the reptiles, the heart becomes 3.5 chamber. We can't call it the 4 chamber because this partition is not completely. It's a little bit partition is there. So this kind of heart is known as 3.5 chamber heart. ये सब evolution के साथ साथ हो रहा है. और साथ ही हम देख रहे हैं कि accessory जो chambers थे, उनमें भी changes आते जा रहे हैं. Conus arteriosus जो था amphibian के केस में conus arteriosus will convert into the truncus arteriosus, but here in the case of reptiles again the truncus arteriosus converted into the 3 main blood vessels. और वो blood vessels कौन सी है? 2 यहाँ पे बन रही है systemic arch और 1 जो यहाँ पे form हो रही है वो है pulmonary arch. First let's see what the blood circulation, उसके बाद हम इसकी बात करेंगे truncus arteriosus की. Here the left atrium it's received the oxygenated blood from the lungs. So in the right and left atrium oxygenated blood comes from the lungs, whereas the right atrium it's received the deoxygenated blood from the sinus venosus. So this is the sinus venosus which is receiving the deoxygenated blood, and finally this deoxygenated blood comes into the right atrium. From the right atrium this deoxygenated blood goes to the this part of the ventricle, whereas oxygenated blood goes to the this part of the ventricles. As the partition is not completely, it's a partial dividation, so blood can be mixed. Blood की mixing हो जाती है. So here, in the case of the ventricles, the blood which is present here is a mixed blood. Ventricles में जो blood होगा, वो blood mixed blood ही होगा. This kind of the heart which contain or which supplies the mixed blood is known as atriovenous heart. ये हमने amphibians के cases में भी देखा था, where the fish's heart is known as venous heart, amphibians and the reptiles' heart known as atriovenous heart. It's also an atriovenous heart because it supplies the deoxygenated or it supplies the mixed blood to the body parts. Now let's see what is forming here. This mixed blood is will transport it to the truncus arteriosus, which is converted into the blood vessels. अब यहाँ पे जो blood vessels हैं ये क्यों बनी हैं? अगर हम evolution पे जाएं तो हमें पता है कि after the reptiles the next higher group is the birds and mammals. They will come. The birds and mammals has a highly developed animals where the pulmonary and the systemic arch is formed. The systemic arch is received. This is the main aorta is formed, which is transport the blood, oxygenated blood to the all complete body parts. Where the pulmonary vein, which the pulmonary artery, sorry, this pulmonary arch is formed, which carries the oxygenated deoxygenated blood to the lungs. So evolution के साथ साथ क्या होने वाला है यहाँ पे कि धीरे-धीरे ये जो septum से completely divide हो जाएगा. ये septum जो है completely form होगा and the ventricles will completely divide into the 2 different ventricles. The left ventricle and the right ventricle. As we see that right ventricle is receiving the deoxygenated blood. So this deoxygenated blood has to go to the lungs. Ye lungs, pulmonary arch jo hai, it will goes to the lungs. So pulmonary arch will carry the deoxygenated blood and divide, transport this blood to the both of the lungs. In the case of the evolution, then next level which the next group will show the this kind of the transportation. Similarly, that left atrium it has the oxygenated blood, and this oxygenated blood has to go to the body parts, and it will go through the systemic arch. तो ये systemic arch से जाएगा. So ये evolution के बाद ये चीज होनी है, हो रही है इन groups के अंदर. But यहाँ पे जैसा कि completely divideation नहीं हुआ है, still the ventricles are divided, not completely divided. The blood is mixed. So through this systemic arch and the pulmonary arch both will transport the mixed blood to the different body parts. So here also the mixed blood is transported through the pulmonary arch and the through the systemic arch. This kind of circulation is also known as double circulation. In the case of amphibian also there was the circulation is the double circulation. They will also show, reptilians will also show the double circulation, because the blood is transported through the heart 2 times before being transported to the body organ. One in the form of the oxygenated blood and second in the form of deoxygenated blood. So this type of circulation is known as double circulation. This is also the double circulation. So this is about the reptilian's heart, where the heart is a 3-ion chamber heart. But some exceptions are there. The exceptions कौन-कौन से? यहाँ पे हम वो exceptions देख लेते हैं, which do not show this kind of 3.5 chamber heart. They have completely divided 4 chamber heart. And the exceptions are the crocodiles, alligator, and gavialis. Gavialis, these are the animals which are the reptiles, but being reptiles, they show the four-chambered heart. So crocodile, alligator and gavials, they have the four-chambered heart. Rest all the reptiles, they have three and half chambered heart. So this is about the heart of the fishes, amphibians and reptiles. Now, when we talk about the heart of the birds and mammals, in the case of the birds and mammals, the heart is completely divided into four chambers. Upper two chambers are the atrium, lower two chambers are the ventricles, and the accessory chambers, these accessory chambers are completely converted, like sinus venosus is also reduced, and the truncus arteriosus is converted into the main blood vessels. So in this case, we can say that the birds and mammals has the completely divided four-chambered heart. So we will discuss about the structure of the human heart in the next coming sections. And with this, we will discuss about the what are the differences are there which makes the bird hearts different from the mammalian heart.